Hi, my name is Yolanda, and in this series, I share my adventure in Puglia. I'm going to select one of Italy's biggest treasures, a Mugese horse. The Mugese is an ancient horse breed named after the rocky hills of the Murcia, the place where Holy Roman Emperor Frederick II started to breed war horses in the 1200s. The horse I select will be the first Mugese to fly to the United States of America. I'm a Dutch-Italian horse professional and grew up in the Netherlands. Because of my southern Italian roots, I've always been fascinated by this Italian horse breed. Many years ago, I selected my own Mugese in Puglia. I saddle broke and schooled him myself. You might have heard of him. His name is Carletto. He became the world's first Grand Prix Mugese horse, competing in the highest level of the sport. Now let's go to Puglia to find another top horse.
We are in the Murcia. Mamma mia. Unbelievable. Nou, we rijden nu echt door het park van de Murcia. Nationaal Park. Je ziet hier dat het iets hoger ligt, heuvelachtig, dan die witte rotsen. We are in the Murcia. How special. I'm so happy to be here. It's really amazing. Really an honor.
This is Castel del Monte. And this is where it all started with the Mugese, because the men that built this castle started to breed war horses in this area.
Yeah, this is the area where the Mugese horse comes from. That's why it's called the Mugese. And behind me, there is the castle of Federico II. And he developed war horses in this area. He chose the Murcia because the ground is very rocky. There's a lot of minerals in the ground. And the horses, they really develop very strong hooves and strong tendons. And this was very important because he needed to have horses to ride long distances. Because he was also the emperor of Sicily, and he had to go from up to all the way down to Sicily on the horse. Because there were no cars in those times, no planes. So it was important he developed a horse that he could do this with. There are a lot of descriptions about all his philosophy about what is important to in a horse. And the Mugese of today is still very close to this philosophy.
This is the typical rocks from Puglia. Stones, you see it everywhere. Really, this ground is made of this. I always find it fascinating when I see flowers growing through the rocks. Beautiful. I'm going to do something a little bit bad. I'm going to bring a stone from the Murcia. And I'm going to bring it to Carletto. Because Carletto comes from this place. Normally I do not bring things from nature. Because I think it belongs in nature, but this stone belongs also with my Mugese horse. I bring it with me to the Netherlands.
I can already see Castel del Monte. Beautiful. But yeah, I'm so excited to go to this castle. I wanted to go to this castle for a long time. I've been many times to Puglia, but never visited this castle. Weg naar Castel del Monte en er is een hele donkere lucht. Volgens mij gaat het zo regenen. Ik heb mijn jas aangetrokken, dus daar gaan we.
Bij het kasteel mag je niet parkeren, dus het is een stukje lopen. Ik denk wel dat het een uurtje lopen is. Bring them home.
There's another one. They're guiding me to the castle.
Don't walk through the world looking for evidence that you don't belong, because you will always find it. Don't walk through the world looking for evidence that you're not enough, because you'll always find it. Our worth and our belonging are not negotiated with other people. We carry those inside of our hearts. I know who I am. I'm clear about that. And I'm not going to negotiate that with you. Because then I may fit in for you, but I no longer belong to myself. And that is a betrayal I am not willing to do anymore.
It's really strange. So in the middle of the castle, there is this. It's almost like they used it for UFO landing. Like it's square, everything is symmetrical. It's really a sort of war place where you have to defend.
It's so strange, this shape. You can read also that this is has Islamic origins and a mix of North European futures. It's very special. It's really a mix. You don't see that very often.
I wonder what this top was for. Maybe to put some for the enemy something. Lava down or something. It's so beautiful. Look at the stone. It's all red. It's marmor. This one is blue. It's nice.
Frederick was born in 1194. He was a German king. King of Sicily and Emperor of the Holy Roman Empire. In his time he was known as Stupor Mundi, amazement of the world. He spoke six languages: Latin, Arabic, German, Sicilian, French and Greek. He was interested in philosophy and science. Frederick also wrote a manuscript about the art of hunting with birds. He chose Puglia to breed horses because of its rocky grounds. He wanted to have war horses with hard hooves and tendons that could handle long distance traveling. He died in Puglia in 1250. Especially the south of Italy has a lot of interesting equestrian history that has influenced the horse world until today.
And unfortunately, in Puglia, there are not a lot of horse trainers. So it's not like Spain and Portugal. You really have the culture also that they know how to develop the horse. You have some good trainers here also. I don't say that there are none of them, but in general, they are not trained. Now you can really recognize where are the cities, because they are made of these white stones. And it's shining of white. Here also another city. See it here.
Now today we bought something local. We didn't go to a restaurant. This is Artarelli. Typical Pugliese. Just some olives. It's a verdura vegetable. What is it again? I don't remember which vegetable it is in English. I have no idea how to say it. Pomodoro secchi, dried, tomatoes. my husband took some cheese. Some fragole, strawberries. And this one, green vegetable. Un calcio cavallo. It means the kick of a horse. This is cheese.
Un kick of a horse. Cascio e formaggio.
Oh, scusa. Calcio cavallo?
No, calcio, cascio.
Ah, cacio, oh scusa. Ok, cacio cavallo.
I go to eat and then I go to rest, and tomorrow there's another day of horse searching. So if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe, and I see you in the next one.